Folks, this is Travis of Elston Equine Solutions in partnership with the Clopton Cow Company, as you know. And I had an interesting email from Skylar H. out of Nebraska, and his question was how to tie stopper knots onto a metal Hondo, or in this case, a rawhide Hondo or plastic Hondo, this one being a breakaway. So this is an interesting thing and a topic, and this is the reason why. Long time ago, I was with my mentor, the late Peter Campbell, and I can remember we were riding in his clinic, and Peter walks up to a guy, we're doing roping, and said, let me look at your rope. And the guy asked, well, what type of a stopper knot should I said? And Peter looks down on his stuff and goes, you know what? You shouldn't be using a Turk's head. You need to use Mathew Walker. And the old guy was kind of stumped there, you could see it, but he's going to take word of a famous clinician, and Peter really was, and one heck of a wonderful clinician, horseman, and knew everything in the buckaroo world, and you know, because of him, I always tied Mathew Walker knot too. So later on down the road, went, met a whole bunch of buckaroos and different people, and they're like, no, you gotta use Turk heads. And I'm like, huh, interesting. So as a treasure and being part detective and being nosy, I decided I would kind of figure out, okay, what stopper knot should you use? So don't worry, I did the groundwork for you. So I went ahead and got a hold of Cactus Ropes, and I said, emailed them and said, what type of stopper knot do you use? And they said, well, we use Turk's head. Okay, well, I appreciate it. And they said, thank you for asking. So then I got a hold of King Ropes out of Sheridan, Wyoming, and they came back and said, we use the Mathew Walker knot. So those are two main rope companies out there making ranch ropes and buckaroo ropes out there. So then I went ahead and got a hold of four clinicians I know of, and many more before them replied back, and I had two of them come back, and they used Turk's head, and the other two used Mathew Walker's. So then I'm like, okay, well, let me pull this, do a poll on my YouTube channel and see what happens. So 43% of you use the Mathew Walker. 57% of you use the Turk's head. So I'm like, huh. Okay, who's out there that's pros doing Pro-Am, the Buck Brand Pro-Am? And they do have a horsemanship award out there for the late Peter Campbell. So I got a hold of four of them, okay, replied back, and three out of the four use the Mathew Walker. Only one uses the Turk heads on that one. So that's the Pro-Am, the pros, top line, big loop ropers. All right, so I'm like, huh. Kind of interesting. Was there any publications out there? So I went and got a hold of Knots and Hitches and Their Uses by John Sharp, and this book was dated, first came out 1966. So I looked in here, said, geez, there's a wealth of information in here. Should I use a Mathew Walker or should I use a Turk's head? So I went ahead and looked in here and said, well, the diamond knot is also called the Turk's head in some localities, one of the best knots to tie off the end of a rope. So I was like, okay. But then it went and said the crown knot and the wall knot, some people call them Turk's heads, okay? So when I started looking at publications, looking at the top of the food chain, it wasn't stopper knot to use, I came up with one conclusion, I'm sure you have already. it's always going to be a debate. It's a personal choice which one you're going to use. Just like some people like to drink Coke. Some people like to drink Pepsi. Some people like to drive a Ford. Some people drive a Chevy. You go to pistols, you always have the big debate. 1911 versus the Glock. Okay? So you always have these different camps, and there'll probably always be that camp, all right, of what is better than others, okay? So the end of the story is, it doesn't matter if you use a Mathew Walker. It doesn't matter if you use a Turk's head. So what I'm going to do is let you decide. I'm going to show you how to tie both knots in this video. I'm going to start off with the Mathew Walker, and then I'm going to show you how to tie Turk's head. I'm going to use a big strand of cotton rope first, and then so you can see the strands where they go. And then I'm going to go down to a 3/8 scant ranch rope that I use and show you on that. Okay, so there you go. That's the investigation. And now we're going to show you how to tie both these knots. Alright, so here's a quick tip from Travis. You don't have to do it if you don't want to, but I highly encourage it and recommend it. If you're trying to learn how to tie the Mathew Walker knot or the Turkhead knot, make sure you use an old rope first before you go out to that nice, brand new, unused rope that you have, and you try to do the knots and it gets all chewed up, something bad, and turns into a booger knot. You know, then you got to cut it, you shorten it, and then you got to start over again, put your Hondo. Pretty soon you went from 60 foot down who knows to what, you know, 45 feet if you had to practice that much. So take my advice, get an old rope, kind of like this. This is an old rope, and I've just been showing some knots on here and just been practicing my own self just so I could tie one knot and a different knot to show you exactly what the difference are on these once again, okay? So on this side here, and we'll get a close-up, you'll see that this is a Mathew Walker knot, okay? And I do have video in depth on this one, and this is the Turkhead's. So all I did was tie one on each end of the rope so you could see the difference in the two, okay? Mathew, it goes straight up top. The Turk's head right out to the side here. So I just kind of wanted to show you a side view of what it looks like, and then take another angle and show you what it looks like from the bottom. Now remember, my left hand is the Mathew Walker, my right hand over here is the Turk's head, and I'm showing you this so you can really study it hard and compare it to the knots that you are tying. Whether you're tying the Mathew Walker or the Turk's head, or tying both, doesn't matter, whatever you use, at least you got something to go off of, okay? And I left these on here just so you can see what it looks like and compare it to mine. All right. So I hope this helps you out. All right. So a three strand Mathew Walker knot. All it is a series of overhand knots connected to each other. So I'm just going to show you an overhand knot. All you're doing is creating a bite, going through the bite to create a loop. Okay. And then there's going to be a series, another strand doing the same thing, another strand going the same thing, which is what I'm going to do next. Okay. All right, folks, so I'm going to show you the Mathew Walker stopper knot. And I got them color-coded. I got green, white or clear, then also the red. Now you'll see I have all the strands going to the right, and I have the top strand, okay, still going to the right. So the green one, all I'm going to do is go all the way around the other two strands. And all I'm going to do is an overhand knot. Coming not through this way, but up through the bottom. And I'm going to pull it right through. Okay. Now what I'm going to do is take the middle knot, which is the clear white one. I'm going to go behind, follow the same pattern, behind the green one. And I am just going to go up next to my green strand, back up through itself. Okay, you can see the pattern here. Okay, so that's what I got right now. Now I'm going to take my last one, the red one, go behind everything. Go up next by the white one. And back up through itself. Pull it tight. And then I'm going to pull my green one first. Pull my white one. And I'm slowly just going to work everything up. And I'm just kind of finessing it up. And I'll pull again. And feed everything the best I can. And you just take the bottom loops and you kind of push them together nice and easy like. I'm just cleaning it up. Cleaning it up. And I'll pull. And I'll pull. And I'll pull. And we'll use a set of pliers. And I'm just going a clockwise direction grabbing these strands. Green, white, red, green, white, red strand. Okay. And I'm just pulling it tight. Now, if you got your Hondo's just going to slide up. You go into it, which will show on the catch rope here shortly. And what you have as spot check is you have three lines going up the top. One, two, three. I go to the side. I have two. Two. And two, pretty much everywhere you look. So that is a Mathew Walker knot right there. And then of course, if I had a Hondo, what I would do is cut these down, which we're gonna show you on the catch rope, and then melt it down, okay? So that's how you do a Mathew Walker on the big strand. So I hope that helps you out. One. Okay, what we got here is a three strand catch rope, just like in the previous video using the large strand cotton rope. And what we're going to do is take, in this case, rawhide Hondo and slide down the rope. Now, this stopper knot, Mathew Walker stopper knot, you can use on a metal Hondo, a rawhide Hondo like this. Some people call them Hondos. You can use a plastic one, breakaway to put on, it doesn't matter. This knot will help with all of them. Now, when I slide this rope through this hole, you can see the strands are laying to the right. So I'm just going to twist it over to the right so I don't disrupt the lay of the rope when I put this on. Okay. And then when I get to a certain point, all I'm going to do is slide the Hondo, or Honda, depending on what region of the country you're in. And then I'm going to take my strands and unravel them. I'm going to go down approximately around 6 inches. So I got plenty to work with here. I know it's 6 inches, because I'm taking my hand plus a thumb length, okay? Just as food for thought. Now you'll see I got three strands, just like the cotton large rope that we had earlier. I got my strands, lays are going to the right, laying to the right, all these strands. So I'm going to have strand one, strand two, strand three. You can see the ones laying to the right. That's why, how I want to hold it. So I'm going to go behind everything, keep an open space, and create an overhand knot. Take strand number two, create an open loop. Go up the hole, created, make sure you enter the hole of line one. So I'm going parallel to this strand of line one, as you can see. And then go right into the hole of line two that we started. And I'm going to keep that hole open. Now I take line three, create a hole, go behind everything. And I'm going to go parallel to line two here. Come up, and I know it's kind of hard to see, that's why I had that big rope, and then I'm going to go right through, remember that hole that I had from my original one, which is here, okay? And then I'm slowly going to adjust the third strand first before I do the rest of them. It's a little bit easier. Now I'm going to pull and feed through, tracing all the way up to strand one. Pull it. A lot of finesse. Go to strand two. Push it around. Follow it. Notice I'm just not pulling the strand. I'm working where the closest to the rope and pushing it into where I need to go. Okay. Nice and easy like. Follow this one. Push it around. And all you're doing is just retracing everything, just slowly tighten everything up, okay? Clean it up nice and neat. And I kind of help the rope kind of roll with itself, okay? You see how this strand's way over here? I'm just going to slowly help it push onto itself. Continue to tighten down. Clean it up, making sure everything's right next to each other. Nice, neat, easy, pleasy. Nice, neat looking. Okay, do my checks. Make sure I got 1, 2, 3 strands up top, just like I did on cotton ones. Come around, make sure I got my two and my two right here, laying next to each other. Nice and easy pleasy. And like I said, you just kind of keep finessing it, following the same pattern you had, pulling down tight, and help the overlays. One strand, two strand, three strand, one strand, two strand, three strand. Okay, and you can see we're down there nice and tight down here. If you go too high pulling this up, what happens is this rope will actually start unstranding itself, and you don't want that. So here's my checks again. I got 1, 2, 3 strands. I got 2 here going all the way around. To another two. So I know I've tied this Mathew walker correctly. Now what I'm going to do is trim the edges here on Mathew walker knot, 3 strand. And a lot of people like, I'm going to leave a little bit of edging because what you're going to want to do is melt. And I never cut towards myself because I don't like to stab myself in the gut. Okay, I'm pretty sure you don't want to see what I ate. I always cut away from myself just for safety, and I make sure nobody's standing in front of me for the same reason. Okay, now we're going to burn it next. Okay, so as soon as I'm at to this point here, and I've done my check on everything, I've made everything tight as I'll get out. You can use a set of pliers to pull them pretty tight, but I got another trick to show you after I burn the ends. So I just take a lighter and just kind of burn the ends here. Now I got a friend that ropes pretty much in the pro-am for a long rope roping competition as a pro, and what he likes to do is take glue around the stopper knot here Right on the other edge, he'll take a glue gun, put glue around it before he pushes the Hondo up, okay? So the final stage here is, I just take my Hondo. Once again, I push it to the right. Fall on my strand lay. Okay. And tell them right here. Now what I like to do is I like to tighten it up quite a bit and just pull on the base of it to make sure that it is locked in tight. And I feel that is. And there we go. So we got a Mathew Walker knot here. Stopper knot right inside the Hondo. And yeah, it works pretty darn good. So there you go. There's your example of tying the Mathew Walker knot. Next, what we'll do is talk about Turk's head knot. Okay, so what I'm going to do today, right now, is do a demonstration on the Turk's head knot. So I'm just going to unravel it a ways. I'm going to unravel it a lot further than I normally would on a catch rope. For the simple fact is, I'm using larger diameter ropes. Now, once again, you see all my lays of this rope are going to the right. And my red, I marked this with tape on it just so you can see the red is the lay going off to the right. My middle rope is the next lay. And my last lay to the left is going to the left, which is the third lay, is going to the left, and that's marking green. Okay. Now, the Turk's head, all you're going to do is I am just going to simply take my red strand, go underneath my white strand, leaving a loop. I'm going to take my white strand, go underneath my green strand. Okay, now you're going to take the green strand, go underneath the white strand, and then take your green strand and go underneath the first one, which is the red strand. Don't go this way. Go underneath. Remember, everything is underneath on this knot. And then I'm going to take my left hand support hand, go to the bottom, and then I'm slowly going to dress this up. And once I hand tighten it, I can grab my pliers and really torque them down nice and neat and good. Now, some people call this a crown knot. Some people will use a diamond knot and say it's a Turk head, same thing with a crown knot. But this is how I was taught to tie a Turk's head. And so therefore, I'm teaching it to you, okay? So what I have is I have a strand here, which is a clear, a locking bar. Got my green strand, lock a bar. I got my red strand. And then I got my locking bar. So you see it just goes in a pattern like this. All right. I'm going to keep drawing it down. Nice and neat. Okay. You see when I really draw it down, it really comes into shape now. Okay, now, not only do I do this knot one time, you just do it again for a second time, okay? So what I mean by that, so this strand right here, I'm just going to take a strand, in this case the white one, and go underneath it. Remember, make sure you still have your loop here. Now I'm going to take my green, go underneath the white strand. Once I have my red strand, I go underneath the green strand. And the red strand goes underneath the first one, which was the white strand. And then we slowly tighten everything up underneath the first knot. and it really becomes a very decorative stopper knot, which is what all these are for. So remember, the first one was the first layer, and now I'm applying the second layer. Okay, so you can see it's definitely a stopper knot. And I got them going out the side just like the demonstration one I gave you. Okay, so there's my checkpoints. Got three strands out to the side, and I got my locking bars. Okay, so my locking bars are fashioned one spacer, two spacer, three spacer. Okay, so spacers, what I mean by that is just the pull tug ones. Okay, so that's all there is to the knot of the Turk's head. And I'm just drawing it down real tight, getting it cleaned up, because I will keep this on this rope, and we'll have, probably have this rope in a video later on being used tying the horse's legs up, okay, as a hobble. So there we go. Nice and easy pleasy. All right, moving on to our catch rope. Okay, so here's my lays going to the right. So this is going to be strand one, because the top, strand two is the middle, strand three is the back, okay, which is this one right here. All I was going to do is go behind, create a bite, go behind. And that's all you're doing, is going behind everything. So now I take the middle strand, go behind. Take the last strand, which is this one right here, go behind. So I'm going behind the middle strand, as you can see. Go straight up from south to north on that first loop that you created. And I'm going to stop there and point this out, okay? So one, there's first loop, there's second loop, and there's a third loop. Now what I'm going to do is just draw it down nice and easy. Using a lot of finesse to be able to dress it up nice and neat, making a delicate little, some people call it flower, I guess, I don't know, but some people think this looks very similar to a crown knot. Some people say a diamond knot is what you're supposed to use for a Turk's head, and then you got your normal Turk's head. Okay, well, most Turk heads start the same and packing or doing the end of a rope in the cowboy world. So that's why I think a lot of people use the Turk's head knot to be able to work on a stopper knot for Hondo. Okay, so I got a bite running in. Okay, come around this, I got a bite and running in. And then I come through, and I got a bite and a running in. So that's what I'm looking at right now for my checkpoints. Now, it's actually two knots. So what we're going to do now is I'm going to create a second knot, same thing underneath. But first, I'm going to take my pliers and tighten everything up. Now what I'm going to do is just grab a strand, doesn't matter which one, and I'm just going to follow everything. So this one goes underneath, keeping that loop open that you remembered. Remember, it goes underneath the middle strand. Underneath the middle strand, I'm going to hold it. Middle strand goes underneath the third strand. Third strand goes underneath, okay, the middle strand, like I said. And we go straight up from south to north up in that bite that we seen, that we started with. And then I'm just going to dress it down nice and neat underneath the first lay of the top Turk's head. And I'm doing it real slow so you can see how this is starting to shape up. It becomes very decorative. Very neat looking. And I'm just tightening every strand up best I can. Okay. So that's the top of it. Here's side going out three directions, and there is another side view. Here's the bottom view, just so you can kind of see, compare it for later. So that is how that looks. And then what we do next is we are going to cut off the ends and burn it. So that's what I'm going to do next. Now remember, you cut away from yourself. Not toward yourself, because you don't want to fillet your stomach and show the world what you ate for lunch. And make sure nobody's standing in front of you when you're doing it. Okay, once I'm done with that, I'm just going to burn everything up nice and neat. Okay, this is a nylon rope, so it's going to melt pretty good. You can use gloves. You don't have to use your hands. My hands are so calloused that I get away with doing this. Or you can just use a rock. I'll do the rock next time. You just kind of round it. So everything is equal all the way around, 360 degrees around this knot, so it doesn't throw any weight off of your knot. Go to the next one. Okay. Like that. Okay, what we're going to do next is just slide up the stopper knot, and then we're going to slide up the Hondo and get rid of these strings so it ain't no drag on the rope. These little rappel lines. Okay, just like this. All right, let me slide the Hondo up next. Okay, so last step is just going to bring your Hondo right in the slot, right onto the knot. What I like to do is just pull up on it, make sure it's tight, make sure it's good. And yeah, that's all there is to a Turk's head knot. Nice and easy pleasy. Now I can burn this down a little bit more. I think I will, because it creates drag, and you see it doesn't slide. In a buckaroo rope, you have to be able to slide your Hondo around to undo twists. So I left it there so you could see it and make sure that you can move your Hondo all the way around. In this case, I can't do it, okay? So it's very important to make sure that you have the ends burnt down where they don't come undone. But you can see these two are, third one, I would stop. So I caution on that to give you a quick tip to make sure you do it right on the Turk's head knot. There we go, easy pleasy. And I think I'm gonna leave you with that. I'm gonna trim it down. And yeah, there we go. All right, folks, I hope you enjoyed my channel. I hope you enjoyed the historical information and also the polling I did and the data I pulled to see about the Mathew Walker knot and the Turk's head. And whatever one you use, play with both of them. See which one you like the best, okay? They both work. I won't use any other knot besides these two because you probably won't have a snowball's chance in hell of it staying on there, okay? So at least there's arguments about which one of these is better. I've never really heard of any other knot. It's worth a dang. So there you go. Appreciate tuning in. Now you have the knowledge. Become the solution. Take care now. Adios.